Hi there. My name is Bob Clearmountain, and I've been working with Apogee Electronics to come up with a new plugin. It's called Clearmountain's Domain. And here it is. And basically, what it is actually a whole bunch of effects, all kind of tied together, that do something very similar to the way I mix in the analog world, like on a. Because I mix on a big SSL analog desk, and there's a lot of things I do with delays and reverbs, and harmonizers and de-essers and equalizers, and which is very simple in the analog world. But when you try to do it in the box, it's very difficult to string all those types of plugins together in a coherent manner that actually makes a similar sound to what I get in the analog world. And so we thought maybe we could come up with a plugin that would do it all internally. So here it is. This is the basic page. And you see I've done a bunch of presets that relate to certain songs that I've mixed over the years. Like here's a Run to You guitar solo. There's a live Rolling Stones thing. There's Let's Dance Delay. Let's Dance Horns from the song Let's Dance from David Bowie. There's the song Start Me Up from the Rolling Stones. It's a reverb sound. I got a very similar sound in here. And so that's kind of a starting point. But for people who are mixers that are want to be a bit more creative, you can kind of, what we say under the hood, which is like going under the hood of a car. And you click over here, this is a diagram of the way the sound, signal flow is, but it's also a way to navigate through the different pages. There's four different pages. This is the first input page. There's an input EQ, a delay input EQ, reverb input EQ. There's de-essers for the delay and the reverb, kind of the clears up the top end a little bit. Instead of rolling off top end of your delay, it's, you can keep the top end going in the delay, and you can just get rid of that, those S's coming back in the delay, you know, milliseconds later. This will sync to the tempo of your song, or not, or you can type in a number, a BPM number here, because you can set up a, you know, quarter note, an eighth note. So this is pretty typical for most delay plugins. You have two different delays. You can cross-feed them, so you can send the output of this delay into the input of that delay, so you get like a ping-pong effect, which is very simple to do in here. Sometimes that can be difficult to do in a normal plugin. It's got this really interesting thing. If you have a long delay on one side, and say a shorter delay, so like a dotted eighth to the quarter note, and then this spin is regeneration. So these delays are regenerate. They're not crossing over. They're regenerating onto themselves. But as you can see, the shorter delay was more spin, and so they end up decaying at the same rate. And this is something that I always have to do on the desk. I have to very carefully listen to it and keep adjusting the feedback until I get it to delay, but this does it automatically for you. There's also this delay, what I call blur, but it's really like a saturation or a like a distortion, which you can really crank it and just go make it out to lunch. Usually it's pretty nice right around the bottom part. You can link these EQs together so they both do the same thing. This is for the delay. You can put this before or after the regeneration spin. Let's see. Well, it's got a lot of little things. I mean, I could go on forever, but there's a lot of bits. And then there's also, this is the harmonizer, this pitch. You can either set them to a fixed rate. These are like harmonized delay. Or it's got a random thing that kind of bounces. It's like a automatic double track. Now everything can feed into, we have three different places for impulse response. This is the Apogee studio, where it's an impulse response of our studio, which is like a warm sort of ambience. These are my chambers at home in my mix room, and this is like a bright, short, like a Motown kind of reverb. It's kind of bright, splashy. And then there's a bunch of different ones in here, and we're going to add to these impulse response. These are all ones that we created ourselves. So there's a stairway, which is like a in a parking garage. This is a bathroom that we found in where was it? It was a movie theater. This is the shower in my. I have a little shop, and there's actually a shower in the shop, and I did that. It's kind of not a great sound, but it's interesting sound. And then this is Roscoe Chamber. This Roscoe guy is a guy that owns a studio, and he has this really beautiful live chamber that he let us sample it. And then the gated plate, which is kind of like the Born in the USA snare sound, so I was trying to get that, like from the 80s. You know, and then there's a mixer, which is mixes it all together. So you can turn some things on or off and get your own mix. It affects blend, so if you're running it off an aux end, you would keep it up full wet because your actual signal is coming into the mix part. But if you were going to actually put something on a track, you would put in probably 50% or less, so you get the original signal, of course, and then you get the effect. And that's about it. There's also a random button. This is fun. If you keep hitting that, it just keeps coming up with sort of random different settings, which is kind of interesting. You know, you just go through and it just makes wacky sounds. That's just for fun, really. I don't know if it's useful. Probably not. But anyway, that's about it. And then it's just, the whole idea is that instead of just using presets, I'm hoping that the users will get creative and come up with their own settings, their own presets, and their own sounds. There's a lot of tools there to work with, and they're all very easy to access. And so I hope everybody has fun with it.